Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel, and in this video we're going to be having a look at a Jolteon VMAX deck. I'm going to be covering the other evolutions revealed for Eevee Heals later on down the line, but in today's video we're going to be having a look at Jolteon VMAX, which is going to be coming out in our Evolving Skies expansion. And I don't really think I'm going to be doing a set review for Eevee Heals because the set is pretty small, and I'm going to be waiting until Skyscraping Perfect and Blue Sky Stream to do a set review for the set. But I'm just going to be covering all the decks for the set. I'm going to be covering all the cards for the set in deck showcases. So if you want to see more videos like this, remember to drop a like and subscribe. So without further ado, let's begin. Starting off with Jolteon V. Jolteon V has the attack for one colorless energy, that being Thunder Spear, get do 20 damage to one of your opponent's Pokemon, which isn't too great, and the second attack isn't too great. Again, it only does 60 damage and you're getting flip 4 coins doing 60 damage for each head. The main selling point on this card is honestly just the free retreat. That's the only selling point on this card. And yeah, it's a pretty phenomenal basic. We are actually hoping for more HP, but I'll take what we have. Moving on to the VMAX. The VMAX has the attack Max Thunderclap, that basically says for lightning and colorless, you get to do 100 damage to your opponent's active and 100 damage to one of your opponent's bench Pokemon that has damage counters on it. So we have ways of getting damage counters on. As you saw in the intro of this video, I'm going to be using Galarian Zigzagoon to drop a damage counter on your opponent's bench so that we can get the full effect of the attack. And yeah, we're going to be going for Max Thunderclap throughout this whole game. So let's dive right into the deck list. So starting off with the Pokemon line, we play a 4-4 line of Jolteon V and VMAX. I've gone over the attacks on both V and VMAX. Although I was pretty much hoping for more HP than 300, well, take what we have. 300 HP is something that I'm not really liking myself because it's very, very close to Zacian getting one hit KO on it. So 300 HP was kind of disappointing at first, but it's alright. We play 3 copies of Galarian Zigzagoon here to drop damage counters on our opponent's bench so that we can get the full effect of the attack, doing 100 damage to our opponent's bench. So yeah, we play 1 copy of Marshadow here. Marshadow, the resetting hole ability basically says discard the stadium card in play, then discard this Pokemon. It's a pretty great card as a whole, and it's going to be pretty phenomenal in our meta moving forward because stadium control is going to be everywhere. Just believe me right now that stadium control is going to be insane moving into Chillerant and forward. So yeah, we play 1 copy of the Denny GX here to discard our hand, draw 6 cards. It's a pretty phenomenal consistency option in this decklist. We play 1 copy of Manaphy here. Manaphy, while it's in the active, you get to look at the top 6 cards of your deck and find a Pokemon in there and put it into your hand. So it acts like a great ball every turn. So yeah, it helps us to search out our Pokemon line. We play 1 copy of Orango here with the Primate Wisdom ability, stopping the cards in our top of our deck with a card in our deck. So we can just pair this up with Mewtwo. We can use Mewtwo, put a supporter card on top of our deck, and use Orango to place and pull the supporter card into our hand so we can use it. So yeah, Orango on Mewtwo becomes pretty phenomenal when we are playing Scoop Up Net. So yeah, moving on to the item line, I've gone over the packs that are playing scoop up net in this deck list, but we're playing 4 copies of Quick Ball here. Quick Ball helps us to search out our basics. It's a pretty phenomenal option in deck list styles. We play 2 copies of Reset Stamp here to disrupt our opponent's hand and shorten their hand size. We play 2 copies of Pokemon Communication here for some extra Pokemon search. So between Manaphy, Quick Ball and Pokemon Communication, we have a bunch of ways to search out our attackers. So yeah, I'll play 2 copies of Abelune just for the free cheat. And finally, we play a new tool card here, that being Elemental Badge. And that basically says, if this tool card is attached to a Pokemon with Therion, Vaporeon or Jolteon V in their name, its attack costs a colorless less. So with this attached to a Jolteon V, you get to attack for one lightning energy essentially. So yeah, that's pretty phenomenal. With Elemental Badge, you get to attack for one energy attachment. So yeah, it helps us to attack for one energy attachment, and it's a pretty phenomenal item card, tool card in this deck list. So yeah, let's move on to the supporter line. For the supporter line, we play 3 copies of Shell here because we get to attack for one energy with Elemental Badge. So Shell, we can heal up, we attach one single energy and attack. So like when our opponent hits into us, we can heal up with Shell, discarding one energy and attaching one energy, so we're only losing one energy per Shell. And yeah, Shell becomes a pretty phenomenal option in this deck list if they can't one hit chaos. Play 2 copies of Boss's Orders here to drag a Pokemon from our opponent's bench into the active. You play 4 copies of Professor's Research, discard your hand, draw 7 cards. It's a pretty phenomenal supporter card. We play 2 copies of Erika's Hospitality here. Draw a card for each Pokemon your opponent has in play. It's a pretty phenomenal supporter card. And finally, we play 3 copies of Manny for that extra disruption in our deck list. So yeah, between Shell and Elemental Badge, we can get a lot of healing done and a bunch of attacks off. So yeah. Next up, we play 3 copies of Path to the Peak here. Path to the Peak stops Wobbox Pokemon from having abilities. It basically shuts down Crobat, Dedenne, and all abilities your opponent may be relying on. So this is a pretty dangerous combo with Recess Stamp, and that's why I play 2 copies of Recess Stamp. And yeah, it just helps us to lock our opponents so that we can realistically just KO our opponent and keep on piling damage on our opponent's board while slowing down our opponent enough so that we can take KOs and hopefully win the game. So yeah, this stadium card is pretty phenomenal. And finally, moving on to the energy line. For our energies, we play 6 copies of basic lightning energy. As I said, we need to play our lightning energies so that we can attach one lightning energy, Shell, and attach again. So between lightning energy and speed lightning energy, we have a bunch of ways to heal up Shell and also get some extra draws in with speed lightning energy. When we attach it, we draw 2 cards. It's a pretty phenomenal card in any lightning deck you're playing. So yeah. So moving on to how this deck list should work if you're playing it. Right, let's say we're up against an Eternatus VMAX and they have 2 energies on and we have a Path to the Peak in play. Realistically, we should have a Path to the Peak. We have we are playing 3 copies of Path to the Peak and Marshadow, so we should have Stadium Control. Sorry guys for that interference. Let's say we're up against an Eternatus decklist with an Elemental Badge attached. We attach an Elemental Badge from our hand to our Jolteon in the active so that we get to attack for one colorless energy less. So yeah, we attach an Elemental Badge, then we play down a Galarian Zigzagoon. You drop a damage counter on one of our opponent's bench Pokemon so that we can get the full effect of the attack with Jolteon V Max Thunderclap. We drop down a Galarian Zigzagoon, dropping a 10 damage counter, let's say on the Crobat V, the bench Crobat V, and yeah, we just attack from then. We do 100 damage to the active Eternatus and 110 damage to our opponent's bench Crobat. So it goes back into our opponent's turn and they attack into us, and because of Path to the Peak, they can only have 5 bench Pokemon in play, so Eternatus only does 150 damage rather than 270 damage. And even if they are doing 270, we have ways of getting around this. So we just play down a Shell, heal up all the damage from Jolteon V, heal up 150 damage or up to 270 damage and beyond with shell. And then we just attach another basic lightning energy and attack again. So we just keep on rinsing and repeating this combo. Until we eventually win the game, because our opponent can't keep on attacking to us, and we will just keep on healing up the damage while their bench is piling up damage. Their bench Pokemon is piling up damage while their active Pokemon too is piling up damage. So yeah, this is a pretty phenomenal deck, and the Jolteon attacking for one lightning energy is also pretty phenomenal. Let's take a look at the deck list. Here's the first deck list I was telling you about or showcasing to you. As you can see, we play our Jolteon line, our Galarian Zigzagoon, our Manaphy to help us search out our Pokemon, our copies of Elemental Badge, and we play 4 copies here because of we still have 2 Scrapper in the format, and we still have that Lipad that's going to be coming out in Chilling that discards 2 cards attached to your opponent's Pokemon. So yeah, that's why I play 4 copies of Elemental Badge here. You never want to go lower than 3 copies of Elemental Badge in your deck list. So yeah, here's another deck list that plays Orbeetle. I'm choosing to play Orbeetle here because it drops the damage counter on each of our opponent's bench Pokemon. So between Max Thunderclap and Orbeetle's Airy Beam, we are spreading a bunch of damage counters on our opponent's field while healing up with Shell. And yeah, we can also use Orbeetle here as a backup attacker. As you all know, Jolteon V and VMAX has a crippling weakness to fighting, and we still have a Shifu VMAX in the format. So having Orbeetle here to cover your weakness is pretty phenomenal. And we just play a bunch of switching options here so that we can retreat with our Orbeetle. And yeah, that's basically the deck list. I also have a couple of post-station deck lists to show you guys here. Here's the first deck list that's mirroring the other deck I just showed you just a couple of moments ago. Yeah, and yeah, it's pretty self-explanatory. I also have another deck list to show you, the second deck list. As you can see here, most of the deck lists I just showed you can be easily brought into post-rotation quite easily, and you can easily fine-tune them to your own build or however you like, and they are pretty interchangeable and you can easily build around it. So yeah, that's gonna be Jolteon V, and that's gonna wrap up the video. Remember guys to drop a like and subscribe if you find this content nice and you enjoy this content, and tell me what evolution you want to see me cover next and what's your favorite evolution. And yeah, I'm gonna catch you guys next time. Peace out.